What's up, snake fans? Dave Palumbo here for Muscle Serpents Daily. And I just did a really nice tour of my facility with a bunch of young kids. I should have filmed it. I didn't have anyone here with me, so I couldn't do it. So anyway, I got all excited about my collection. So I went around and I started filming a lot of cool stuff, like my green tree python babies and some of the cool ball pythons I produced this past year. So you guys are gonna get to see what got me excited about the tour that I gave and some of the cool snakes that I got and how they're growing and progressing, including my Anchee Clown Pied Banana Project, which is one of my favorites of 2022. So guys, stay tuned, check this out. All right, I got my daughter Aria here. She's home from school, not feeling too well today, right? Although you look like you're good now. You ready to go back?
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right, we're looking at our super fire diamond here. Beautiful girl being bred by a fire diamond male.
I really like the white one.
Yeah, the white one is beautiful. We can make more white ones with these two. That's the goal. Now, they're obviously not locked right now, but he's definitely hanging out on top of her there. So that's a good sign. And hopefully we'll see some babies later this year. She's very big, that's for sure. She actually looks like she might be going through an ovulation right now. Look at that. I didn't even notice that. I just saw that. See this big bulge here, Aria?
Yeah.
We didn't feed this snake. And that bulge, it means that she's probably ovulating. And that's when all the little follicles, which are going to be eggs that turn into little babies, move into the oviduct. And that's
good. I knew you were
going to say that. You did? I don't think you know what I was going to say. But if that is an ovulation, then that is a good sign that we possibly might have some babies in the future coming out here.
Yeah.
120 days or so. All right, guys. Look at this. That is nice. We showed you these snakes the other day. They weren't breeding, though. But look how cute they are you? Look at them. They got their heads right next to each other.
Yeah.
That's cute, right?
The brown and black and yellow brown one, it is so cute.
Yeah, that's the big scoria female we have. That's also het for blood and parahet, and that's our parahet het blood male, and they're definitely locked over there, so that's a good sign. Boa breeding is going well this year.
Well, with the brown, the brown black one is.
You're talking about the little boy on top,
no.
Or the girl on the bottom.
The girl on the bottom.
Yeah, she's a scoria boa.
And she's so big.
She's big. The females are always bigger than boas, pretty much. Now let's leave them alone. I got more boa breeding here. This is a busy day today for breeding. I don't want to startle these guys. This is my, let me see which one this one is. T positive Gilbert, 66% het leopard and 66% het blood female. And we're breeding it to a het blood, het Gilbert, 100% het leopard. So triple het essentially. And I see some locking action there, so that's good. I don't want to bother them because they seem to be getting a little disrupted by me, but they are breeding. So this is when I first discovered that I had the Gilbert T positive line here. I don't even think Chris Gilbert knew we had that in the collection. He found it. I found it at the same time, breeding what I thought to be a double het to a double het leopard blood, a double het blood, and we got T positive. So I kept back the Gilbert T positive, and I'm breeding it back to the father. Let's see what we hit. Look at this big boy. Albino sulcata tortoise. Oh, is he getting so beautiful and so big? Look at him. He's bigger than my hand now. I can't believe it. He's got to go. I know I keep saying I got to get him outside. I'm going to get him outside. I'm going to build him. I have my friend Chase, who is building me my outdoor enclosures, is giving me some ideas of how to maybe put some pavers into the ground so that he can't get out. We're gonna have to maybe, you know, rope off, or not really rope off, I guess we would cement off an area where we can make a barrier so he can't get out. And him and his girlfriend over there, who's buried herself for the night, she's going to sleep for the night, they're gonna have fun outside. I'm gonna have to build them a little house that's heated so they can go in there and get heat if they need it. And hopefully they're gonna do really well outside. That's always been the goal. I just was, you know, worried that they weren't big enough. I think they finally are. I'm excited to get these guys outdoors, eating real grass. All right, baby green tree pythons. We love our baby green trees. They're doing well. So a couple of them ate for Pablo, pinky heads. Some of them didn't. And they're looking really good though still. I have a feeling we're gonna have a problem with getting them to start eating maybe, but we're trying all the tricks. We're rubbing chick down on them, which is the chick fur when the chicks are first born. We're rubbing them on the pinkies. We're trying to get them to eat. I think once they start eating, then you're pretty good, but so far we haven't got, we only got two to start eating out of the seven, and we'll just keep persisting. Eventually we'll get them all to eat, hopefully. Here's a real cutie right here. It's funny, they're really good personality. They're not really biters or anything like that. They're pretty mellow. I figure if I handle them a little bit, not a lot, but once a week, just get them used to being handled. All they know is me and Pablo from the moment they were born. Hopefully we will maybe get them to be able to tolerate being handled as they get older, because sometimes these guys like to bite and they have very big teeth, so it's not a fun bite. I've been bitten by a couple of these, and while I don't really mind it, it's not something I look forward to. So they're cool, super cool. Love these guys. All right, little update on my banana enchi clowns that are 66% het pied. Looking really, really cool. This is my male. I love enchi clowns. And nothing better than adding a little banana in there, right, for good measure. This is banana enchi clown, het, 66% het pied. Here is, she's got a sister someplace. He's got a sister, I should say. All right, there's the sister. That's banana enchi clown. 66% have pied as well. Putting on some nice size. I might make some of these available. I'd love to keep them all, but sometimes that's just not feasible. I really like the way the banana and enchi interact with the clown. There's a really nice epistatic relationship there for sure. Now let's take a look at what the banana clown pied looks like, visual. All right, this girl has gotten better since she's gotten older. This is a banana clown pied, no enchi in this one. We would have a lot less white if there was enchi in there, and you'd be able to see that pretty easily. So this is banana clown pied. This is the snake I've been trying to hit since I started breeding snakes. I used to kid around because no one even had clown pies back then. And I used to say, can you imagine what a banana clown pie would look like? Man, I would love to have one of those. And yep, I made one, so that's really cool. We'll be keeping this little girl back, and hopefully she'll be a really good breeder for us. And here's a beautiful, just clown pie. So this is just the one copy of clown, or I should say two copies of the clown gene, two copies of the pie gene. We got the visual clown pied here. And just, this alone is really, really nice. Because we got that nice clown head. We have the pied mixed in, breaking up the clown pattern. Cool. Now the only thing cooler than this is adding enchi. All right, now this is a different, these are two are from a different litter. This is our female and this is our male. These are enchi clown pieds, so the double recessive plus the enchi, making it very low white pied, which is what we like, so we can put infuse it with more genes and not lose all those genes, because if you have too much white you really don't even see what you got. So enchi with clown and pied together work really, really well. You can see these are much older, getting bigger. They're already spreading their pattern out a little bit more than the babies I showed you. And these two are most likely holdbacks. I might, there's always a possibility I might sell some, but I'm trying to really build up my collection of pied clown visuals so that moving forward I can be pushing exclusively with those two genes in all the different morph combinations. So, love what I'm seeing. All right, guys, that's gonna do it for today. Quickie, but goodie. You got to see some cool, cool stuff. I think tomorrow I'm going to do some rainbow stuff because I have some really good rainbow projects coming up for the coming year. I want to talk about that. But today was about a lot of little things, but I really love my banana clown pied, man. That might have been my favorite snake that I produced in 2022. I think I have to say that that's it. Because I've wanted it before anyone even thought to make it. I was thinking about that snake, and I didn't even know how I would do it. I wasn't even taking steps to get there. That's the funny thing. I was so happy that I was actually able to buy a banana clown, or I think at the time it was a banana pastel clown. I bought one from Garrick DeMeyer, and it was like my favorite snake. I called it Picasso. I even named it, and I used to show it to everyone. And it was just, I thought it was the greatest snake of all time. I said, nothing can top this. I said, the only thing that can top this is if we can put clown into this, and no one could do that. That's going to take 100 years. Well, it's not 100 years later. It's probably only about 8 years later, and sure enough, we got banana clown pied, so it's all good. You got to have a vision at some point and just think about it a lot, and eventually, you'll find a way to make it happen. And on those wise words, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button. Turn on those notifications. Hit that like button. I'll see you back tomorrow morning.